Good morning, Count Corlett. Count Corlett, I welcome the debate here today, and I think everybody in the House would be agreed that certainly it's time to see more transparency in terms of understanding our overall food agri-sector, the challenges facing particularly our primary producers, and understanding also how we actually, what we make finds its way to end markets and what the supply chain considerations are within that. So I think there is a need for a significant review and analysis of the food agri-sector, but particularly the challenges facing the beef sector. We've had significant national discussions in the House in recent weeks on sustainability. It's the new buzzword in our economy. Environmental sustainability, social sustainability, economic sustainability. But what does it actually mean? The environmental challenges that revolve around greenhouse gas reduction, the intensification of our food agri sector, seem to be in opposition. Social sustainability, I think we can understand it as what I would describe it as, the retention of regional and rural Ireland into the future with a vibrant and a viable economy. And the economic sustainability of Ireland Inc. to be able to produce, export as we are an exporting nation, to be competitive in future exporting. The beef sector has 70,000 beef farmers, 10,000 jobs involved in processing, over 2.5 annual euro billion annually to the Exchequer, the fifth largest producer of beef in the world. A very important agri-sector and a very important sector in its own right. But there are questions about who controls the market, and certainly it's not the primary producers. But is it the processors? Well, the processors have a part to play, but I would suggest to the House today and to this debate, a significant part of our problem is at the retailer end and at the end consumer end and what they are prepared to pay for the end product. I have worked in the meat sector for a number of years, many years ago, and I understand fully the difficulties of trying to market within international export markets. And I think who controls the end price is largely dictated to by the consumer, by the multiples and by the activities. And if you're in a meat processing situation, you're subject to meat brokerage and meat arbitrage, which goes on. And some meat cuts will lie around for 12 months before they're sold. And people have to understand there's significant costs within the supply chain. But I would welcome, rather than the appointment of a regulator, I think a food ombudsman that was highlighted under the Beef Task Force. And I think this can do a lot to look at transparency. And I believe farmers need to be careful what they wish for in terms of a regulator. We might also get further regulation within the primary food production end, and that might not be what people need. So I think there needs to be transparency regarding retailing. And I have a particular problem with below-cost selling, loss-leading, which is a significant factor in Irish multiples selling. And I said in the House some weeks ago, Ciarán Corlett, that a pound of pizza, frozen pizza now, sells in supermarkets sometimes for less than Irish choice beef cuts. And that is a significant regret, I would imagine, to everybody in the House. So I think we have to find a way to differentiate the Irish beef export market into the future. I think we have to get government policy involved to align to that process. We must have transparency, certainly within the pricing, and we must see fairness and equity in what is being paid to primary producers. But we must also see a sustainable pathway as to how into the future the farmers are going to receive a ready return and an adequate return on the work that they do, which is so important to our national economy. And as other deputies have said, how we are going to deliver equity and fairness to farmers in the future. Certainly, I welcome the debate today, and I hope the Minister will engage with the House in the future to provide further debate opportunity on this issue. Garmalka Kilcorda.